Measurement Unit, Section 3, Tolerance. Any person that has ever worked with blueprints for a machine component, rebuilt an engine, or fabricated products of steel or iron to a customer's specification has dealt with tolerances. If we have a component that needs to have a length of 23.75 in a real world, that's exactly what we would get. In reality, though, actual production of any product or operation of any system involves some inherent variations without significantly affecting functioning systems, machines, and so on. In this tolerance that's listed here in this slide, the first number is called the standard measurement. It's ideally what we're looking for. Well, the number following the plus minus sign tells you how much the item you can have vary in measurement from the standard value. A variation beyond this tolerance is said to be non-compliant, rejected, or exceeding the tolerance. So if we go to the plus side and determine the maximum by adding on this variation, the maximum length that still would be acceptable turns out to be a 23.875. If we go to the minus side and do the subtraction, we will get the minimum allowable measurement by taking the ideal measurement or standard measurement minus the variation to result in 23.625 inches. We use that range, the maximum and the minimum then, for our tolerance interval to test our parts. And this first one is falling between those values. Next one and next one are fine, but it's this fourth one. It has a value of 23.885, 885 thousandths of an inch, and the maximum can only be 23 and 875 thousandths of an inch. This would be a part that would be rejected, non-compliant, and this last part here has an overall length of 23 and 621 thousandths, which is less than the minimum value, so it too would be rejected. To determine a tolerance interval, we need to know the maximum and the minimum. So here we have our tolerance given with the standard measurement plus or minus the variation. If we add our 1/100th of an inch onto that, the maximum length would be 1.56. If we subtract the variance, we end up with 1.54 for a minimum, and the difference between those two is giving us our tolerance interval. It's found by subtracting the lower or the minimum limit from the upper limit or the maximum. This describes the range of values a component can have. And if we do the subtraction, we end up with 2/100ths of an inch is the variation or the tolerance interval. Here we have another example where we have our standard measurement, 0.785 inches plus or minus 5/10,000ths of an inch. To determine the upper limit, we will add that variation. Lower limit, we will subtract that variation. So here's our upper and lower limits. To find the tolerance interval, we can subtract lower from upper to find that interval. And it turns out to be 1/1000ths of an inch. The other method is, because we're going above our standard measurement by this variance and below the standard measurement by that same variance, we can simply double that variation to get us our tolerance interval. Both are resulting in that same value for the tolerance interval. Sometimes tolerances will be expressed as a percent. And a preliminary step is to translate that percentage into an actual value that we can then add and subtract to find our upper and lower limits. So in this example, the ideal weight is 130 pounds plus or minus 3%. So we need to take the base 130 and times it by the 3%. 3% as a decimal is 0.03, and when we do the multiplication, this turns into a value of 3.9 pounds. This number will replace the 3% variation so that we can then go ahead and add and subtract to determine the upper and lower limits. We'll add 3.9 variation to our standard measurement for the upper limit or the maximum. We will subtract 3.9 from our standard measurement to get the lower limit or minimum. We can either subtract the upper and lower to find the difference for the tolerance interval, or simply multiply our variation by 2 to get the tolerance interval. So from the maximum acceptable to the minimum could have a difference of 7.8 pounds. Here's another example with a percentage given. We have a resistor that has a standard measurement of 2500 ohms plus or minus 2% variation. The preliminary step here is to translate that percentage into a number that we can add and subtract. So we need to determine what 2% of 2500 is. We'll do that by taking the base, the standard measurement, and timesing it by 2%. Expressed as a decimal is 0.02. Doing the multiplication gives us a variation amount of 50 ohms. Once we have the 50 ohms, we're ready to go. To determine the upper limit, we'll do the plus portion. So 2500 plus 50 means the maximum amount acceptable would be 2550 ohms. We'll do the minus or the subtraction of that variation from our standard measurement to get the lower or minimum value. 2500 minus 50 is 2450, and either subtract those two or simply double that variation to give us that tolerance interval. We have a give and take area of acceptable readings that differ no more than 100 ohms from the maximum and to the minimum value. For practice, you can turn in your textbook to page 21 and 22.